This is the world's biggest stage for people transport. A place where ideas are launched, innovations revealed, and where visions are challenged. And today, we will be bringing to you something simple but powerful. A complete and future-ready portfolio built for people transport, built for today and for tomorrow. Because this is more than a product story. This is about something bigger. This is about enabling progress in a world where progress doesn't always come so easily. So let us start to look around us. The world is in growing uncertainty. And our customers, they are navigating this every day. On top of political and regulatory pressure, they are also facing rising social expectations or expectations from the society. The passengers, the next generation, they are asking for action on the climate. The communities, they're asking for cleaner air or quieter streets. And the operator, they're asking themselves, will my investment hold? Will this technology be a safe bet? And will my OEM, my partner, will they be there for me also 5 years down the line? And these are real questions. Because the truth is, it's not only about whether the customer is ready. It's also about whether the conditions even exist. And this is where Scania is determined to play a role. If we can provide solutions that help the operator to profitably transition, then societies will transport more people through shared transport. And shared transport, it gives us cleaner air, it gives us less congestion, and it opens up access for jobs and educations to citizens around the world. So shared transport, it's really about building the society for tomorrow. And to do this, we need to work closely, both with our customers and with politicians and with partners and with infrastructure players. But to succeed, we also need to make choices. And today, I will talk to you about the choices that we have made at Scania. And we will present to you the outcome here at Busworld 2025 of that strategic choice. So I would like to speak to you about three of our strategic pillars and starting to look again at the world around us. In Europe, CO2 legislation and zero emission zones are pushing a rapid transition. In other parts of the world, such as Africa or Latin America, to shift forward may equally mean to scale local fuels, such as biogas, or to upgrade to higher emission classes. And in total, everywhere we look, we see that both infrastructure and energy access tend to lag behind. At Scania, we believe that electrification is the main strategy to decarbonize the transport system. And we are committed to scale it across regions. But we are also, however, aware that not all regions can transition as rapidly. And to reduce emissions, those that bring the climate change, that we must do already today, already here and now. And as a global company, that's why we want to meet our customers where they are. And we want to help them decarbonize with solutions that are highly competitive and available today. Secondly, in this complex landscape, technology alone isn't enough. Our customers, they need trust. Trust that the solution will work. Trust that the partner will stay. Trust that the investment will hold. And that's why we want to create clarity in this complexity. Because we don't chase trends. We commit for the long term. with every customer, in every market, and with every solution. And trust for us is not only built through products, it's also built through our presence, our global service network, our long-standing customer relationships. They help us to tailor support to real-world needs, wherever our customers are. And thirdly, this wide portfolio, it didn't only come by chance. It is a clear strategic choice. We have focused our business to be able to invest in what really matters. And today, we are happy to stand here with a fantastic portfolio in the segments where we have chosen to be present. There isn't one solution for everyone, but there is the right solution for every customer, for every market, and at every stage of their journey. And we've also created the flexibility to choose the right partner in every market. And together with our partners, we offer complete and locally adapted solutions and vehicles, always built on Scania strengths: modularity, total cost of ownership, and uptime. So we are proud to stand here with you and to have vehicles around us with a great performance in new technology and with a continuously improved performance also in the known technologies. We are proud to stand here with a portfolio and have a portfolio where the energy efficiency and the uptime comes as a standard. Because there isn't one size fits all in people transport, but there is one Scania in a global world where we have one portfolio with many solutions. And that is our promise. A complete and future-ready portfolio, grounded in trust, driven by decarbonization, and built with our customers in mind. So with that, I would like to hand over to Karl-Johan Löf, our head of product management, and you will be presenting to us the concrete solutions that bring this strategy to life.
Thank you, Johanna. And let's start with something that we are very excited about, the Scania Super, our new combustion powertrain. This features a fully redesigned 13-liter engine and gearbox, a new rear axle, and more, delivering outstanding energy efficiency with 8% fuel savings. 8%, this is a very big number for many operators, both economically but also environmentally. And keep in mind, this is in comparison with our already highly efficient 13-liter powertrain. Some may ask, why is Scania investing in combustion technology today? But this is not about holding back. It is about moving forward in every segment with the most advanced tools available. This is our best combustion powertrain ever, engineered to reduce both fuel and emission, fully compatible with biofuels like HVO and biodiesel to help further reduce CO2. It has been built to last 25% longer than its predecessors and is prepared to meet future Euro 7 requirements. And it offers real-world performance where electrification isn't yet available. This is how we can help a large share of our customers to decarbonize already today. And for many operators, full electrification isn't feasible yet. Not just because of distance, but because of infrastructure, route flexibility, or charging access still present real barriers. Our new plug-in hybrid platform helps bridge that gap. It gives operators a possibility to meet zero emission demand in city centers while still covering long intercity routes without range anxiety or operational disruptions. The plug-in hybrid has an electrical range of up to 80 kilometers. enough to handle even large zero-emission zones, and it's exceptionally efficient. Utilizing the Super powertrain and its electric components, it enables fuel savings up to 40% in a typical mixed coach operations. This means it's not only contributing to a sustainable development and future-proof our customers' operation, but also substantially lower their operational cost. And with shared platform and serviceability, it supports fleet efficiency and keep costs down. In short, it is a smart, flexible enabler for low and zero emission operations built for the needs of today. The Super engine and electrical machine are displayed right here behind me, and you can also experience them firsthand by taking a tour in our Scania Irisar I6 efficient PHEV outside in Atomium. And please contact our reception to book a tour on that one. But now, let's move to the winner of Sustainable Bus Awards 2025. The gas variant of the Scania Touring. At first glance, you might not notice the transformation, but beneath the surface, the Scania Touring has undergone major updates during the last couple of years. Powered by liquefied biogas, it is a solution with many upsides. Performance and range in pair with a conventional coach, but with lower noise and vibration levels and a CO2 saving of up to 90%. And biogas, it's more than a renewable fuel. It's a tool for circularity. When produced from local waste, it also supports local energy independence and creates local jobs. And coaches like this, they are proof that transition can happen today and doesn't have to mean compromise or heavy investments. But in many cities around the world, electrification isn't just an opportunity. It happens as we speak. And where infrastructure, policy, and ambition aligns, it's fast becoming a requirement. So now let's talk about fully electric products. Starting with a product that will help electrify city and suburban traffic and also shorter regional routes. Our three-axle low-entry electric bus platform, seen here on my left as a complete European-built Scania Irisar i3. Our low-entry BEV products, including the two-axle BEV launched here in 2023, and the new three-axle variant are both reliable and robust. They're ready to handle demanding heavy-duty operation as of today. Characterized by outstanding power and performance and an excellent energy efficiency that enables range up to 550 kilometers, those products are highly competitive. And with several power nodes and battery options to choose from, they can be adapted to the local need for the different operations at the different customers on a global basis. Already today, these buses built on this platform being selected for traffic from the Nordics to the southern part of Europe, from Australia to Latin America. But then, finally, as promised, a completely new product that we are truly excited to premiere here for you at Busworld, our fully electric high-floor bus and coach platform. This comes in both two- and three-axle configuration, making it fully suitable for a wide array of electric operations. The three-axle variant showcased here to my right as a Scania Caetano e-Levante offers an electric range of up to 600 kilometers. Which luggage space comparable to conventional coach. This makes this a solid coach platform, ideal for medium intercity routes, airport shuttles, or tourism traffic. The two-axle variant instead allows for higher focus on passengers and is perfectly suited for slightly shorter intercity routes, school buses, job shuttles, or sightseeing buses. This is what the future of travel can look like. Capability, efficiency, sustainability, all in one package. Me and my colleagues would love to share more with you on our portfolio, our progress, and our strategy. And for that, we will be available here in the stand today and tomorrow, where you can book meetings in the reception. But for now, I would like to re-invite Johanna to the stage to share more.
Thank you, Koyuan. So what have we been showing to you here today? At Busworld 2025, Scania offers a complete portfolio. It's ready to meet today's demands, and it's ready to shape tomorrow's solutions. It is one built on trust, one that helps cut emissions and transition fleets, no matter where the customer is. And it's one that offers not one path, but several, all grounded in operational reality. But this is not just a launch. This is a commitment. From heavy investment in our new foundry to industrializing our battery electric buses and coaches, both in Europe and in Latin America, we are building for the long term. And this is not only to meet today's demands, but it's also to lead tomorrow's transformation. This isn't just a vision, it is happening here and now. So standing here today, we are proud of how we are moving, not just with the times, but ahead of them, and how we are doing it together with purpose. And we are very happy for some news that was brought to us from the Busworld team this Saturday. So I would like to invite on stage Inge Buert. Please, thank you.
Well, I'm very happy to be able to give you this label of excellence in technology driveline. It was the operators in the jury who insisted on giving this because they think it's a practical solution. It gives them the opportunity to make the long distance with a combustion engine and then switch to electricity in the city centers. So this is well earned, I think.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much. It's truly an honor. So,
maybe some applause now.
It's truly an honor. Thank you so much. And with this, we would like to say thank you to all of you attending. We will be, me and my colleagues will be here in the coming few days if you have any more questions. And please do take a ride in the vehicle receiving the prize, the plug-in hybrid. Please speak to our reception. Thank you so much for being here today.
Thank you.